more complete coverage with Matt Schick. This is KTV News Watch 7 Sports.
They have combined for six of the last seven regular season conference championships. This year, Creighton and Southern Illinois are out of the Valley race in a tie for third in the league. That does nothing, though, to dull the rivalry. These two teams do not like each other. Southern looking to stay unbeaten at Quest Center. Jays fans dressed in white for the whiteout game. Creighton races out of the starting eight. Cavell winner coast to coast against the SIUD 26-11. Dana Altman taking part in the whiteout. Later, Kenny Lawson grabbed seven rebounds in the first half. Played a tough game. Hoping the harm here. Jays up 12. Then it's Booker Woodfox shooting from anywhere as long as there's hardwood underneath. The three-pointer there. Woodfox 16 points in the first half to lead all scorers. Jays up 17. Randall Falker, the preseason Valley Player of the Year, a non-factor despite this two. Nice shot, Falker. Jays up 45-26 at the break, shooting 60% from the floor. Second half, Jays get silly. P. Allen Stennett, he's stuck. No, he's fine. Wow, Jays up 21 points. Creighton coaches, yep, that's how we drew it up. Woodfox picking up where he left off, buries the two. One of the quickest releases Dade Altman has ever seen. Booker finished with a game-high 20. Then to cap it off, Woodfox to Stinnett. The jam, P. Allen had 14. Jays win this one running away, 72-53, getting the first win over Southern ever at Quest Center.
Prior to the game, our seniors kind of filled us in and poured the heart out to us and let us know that they haven't had a pretty good record against these guys at the Quest, and so they really wanted to go out with a bang and get this done, and I think we just all came together and really fought for each other.
That was a good win for us. I thought we did a lot of things good tonight and played hard. I thought we had a lot of guys contribute. Offensively, Booker was really good, and Peon was really good. The last three home games, we've made good progress.
They got us. You know, they beat us good, and it's the crowd got behind it, and this is one of the few times when we let the crowd be a major factor in a game here.
More than 15,000 fans saw the Jays go off for 45 points in the first half. That's one more point than they scored the entire game in Carbondale last month. The Jays now all alone in third place in the conference at 8-5. Creighton plays at Evansville Wednesday, at Bradley Saturday. After losing three straight, the Jays have now won three in a row. Drake leading the Valley. They've won 21 straight games. Reports indicate they are very good.